Are you bored of using stock ROM on the RE2 and need more themes and customizability? Well, we've got you covered. Today we will show you how to flash a custom ROM on La Eco's RE2. The ROM we are going to flash is the Resurrection Remix, so let's get started. First of all, you need to enable the developer option from the About section of your settings by tapping build number 7 times. Then go to the developer options and turn on Oem unlocking in USB debugging. We'll need some files. First one is the 15-second Adb installer. Search for 15 seconds Adb in Google or whatever search engine you are using. Open the second link. I'll link all of the links in the description below. I have already downloaded all of the files needed. Next, we need to download the recovery, which is TWRP. Search for TWRP and in the first link, click devices. Search for RE2 in the list. Then click the primary download link and then TWRP 3.0.2 version and then the download button. Then head over to the Resurrection Remix XDA page, which also I will link in the description box below, and download the latest version ROM. Go back and download the gaps. Select ARM64, Android version 6.0 and Nano variant. Now that we have all the files needed, we'll unlock the bootloader and install TWRP. First of all, we need to install Adb drivers. Hit Y to install Adb driver. Hit Y to install device drivers. Now connect your smartphone to your PC. It should be in Media Transfer Protocol option. And go to My Computer, C Drive, and open the folder named ADB. And hit Shift plus right click in blank space and select Open Command Window here. Type ADB devices. It will show you the attached devices and will ask for authorization on your smartphone. Select Always Allow and hit OK. Now type ADB Reboot Bootloader to enter into Fastboot Mode. Now type Fastboot Oem Unlock Go. This will unlock your bootloader. Now type Fastboot Oem Device Info and check for device unlocked true. Now rename your downloaded TWRP recovery as recovery and copy it to ADB folder in C drive. Now type fastboot flash recovery recovery.img. After it's completed, press and hold the power key and volume up key to boot into recovery mode. You can see it booted into the TWRP recovery which we installed earlier. Now here's a flaw with RE2. It will ask for a password to decrypt the data. Just hit cancel, then swipe to allow modifications. Go to wipe tab, then format data and type yes to format all of your internal storage. This will completely wipe out all of your data. So you do have to take a full backup of your files before flashing anything. Now go back to home of TWRP. Go to wipe and select Delvik, cache and data and swipe to wipe. Then copy your ROM and gaps file using an OTG or directly from computer without exiting TWRP. Then go to install and select your ROM file, select add more zips and select gaps file. It will take some time. After it's done, select Wipe Cache and Delvig and swipe. Now your ROM is successfully flashed, select Reboot System. Remember, the first boot after flashing a ROM takes about 5 to 10 minutes, so don't worry, it will boot up. You can see the Resurrection Remix logo, and then it will optimize all the apps, which will also take about 5 to 7 minutes. After booting is finished, you can see the Android welcome screen. I'll skip the process and show you the UI directly. Now you can see the home screen of Android 6 Marshmallow, the notification and quick settings tray of Marshmallow. Let me jump to settings and show you about section. Resurrection Remix version 5.7.4. And Android version 6.0.1. So that's it guys, hit the like button if you found this tutorial helpful and share this with your friends who just got the LE2 and are hoping for some changes. And subscribe for more amazing quality tech content.